The Life Raft book. This is a life raft book for me. It may not be a life raft book for you, but I'm sure you have one.
So that men will not feel left out of this conversation, this book has nothing to do with Jane Austen. It just happened to win the National Book Award for Poetry a few weeks ago. And so I watched it on the internet. I was not at the ceremony. I will be in the future. I'm going to be at a lot of these kind of events in the future, parties, galas, award ceremonies. I'll be winning lots of awards. This or something better now manifests in totally satisfying and fulfilling ways for the good of all concerned. Did you hear that? That's an affirmation. It's that's called creative visualization. So I'm visualizing myself winning a National Book Award. And then I say, well, this or something better now manifests for me in totally satisfying and fulfilling ways for the good of all concerned. That is positive affirmation. I'm not trying to be cocky, but I didn't win the National Book Award this year because I actually don't have a book yet. My book is published. My book is successful. My book is being torn madly, hysterically from bookshelves all over the country, like Harry Potter for adults. That is a positive affirmation. So anyway, when Frank Bidart accepted the National Book Award for Poetry for his book, Half Light, he read this speech. I'm going to read it. It's good. It's hot shit. Art has many mansions. There's always something wrong when we treat it as if it's one mansion, with a discernible hierarchy of values within it. I'm almost twice as old as any of the other finalists. Writing the poems was how I survived. You might well ask, well, is it really a question of survival? My sense is that all human beings alive have enormous schisms in their experience. Terrifying schisms within our feelings and within what we discover the world to be. One premise of art is that anything personal, seen deeply enough, becomes general, becomes impersonal. I hope that the journeys these poems go on will help others to survive as well. That's exactly how I feel about art. Do it to survive, people. Now, speaking of survival, do it to survive. Read it to survive, look at it to survive, make it to survive, write it to survive, survive. And that is why I call this book a life raft book. Because, well, just for example, a few weeks ago, mid-October, 24th, 25th, 26th, I had a very low point. I was feeling kind of hopeless. Now, also, if you think hopelessness is some kind of psychiatric condition, well, we just don't see things the same way. I think hopelessness is normal, and I think hopelessness is especially normal for, well, I can only speak for myself. I don't get too alarmed when I'm hopeless, but I do have to do something about it. I can't just stay in it. So sometimes a book, Pride and Prejudice, I just kind of, one thing led to another, and I got lured into my Pride and Prejudice binge. And so first I started with the radio play that I got from Audible. It was like a BBC version starring Penelope Pinkerstein as Elizabeth Bennet and Sir Reginald Roland as Darcy, you know, that kind of thing. Super dry, super PBS, not PBS, BBC. And it was abridged and it was edited and it was delicious. I didn't care. I don't care how you serve it up. Just serve it up. Bridget Jones' Diary. I'll watch Bridget Jones' Diary. Bridget Jones' Diary is a bastardization of Pride and Prejudice. I'll watch it happily. And I will watch that repeatedly. And these things, they are my life rafts. They get me out of my hopelessness. Why? I can't explain that. That's like another, that's a critical essay, I suppose. And this ain't critical essays. This is just me talking about this book and then throwing this one out there for the guys who don't care about Jane Austen. And I'm reading this. I'm on page 260. What I think about poetry for myself, I don't have a puzzling mind. I don't have a puzzling mind. Like, I don't really, if you, about the blank page, like what's happening in between the lines and between the words that I have to kind of fill in and interpret and guess, my brain just gets tired. But I do think I'm ready. I'm trying. I'm putting this poetry in my vibrational escrow. And reading this book and... That's my critical opinion. And the speech, though. Speech. You might well ask, is it really a question of survival? All human beings alive have enormous schisms in their experience. Not to mention schism. He has two words in here, discernible and schism. Happy to hear him pronounce them because I'm always a little... Both those words. Not that I would say schisms. I know it's schisms. It's a good word. Schism.